हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। हेलो, हाउ आर यू लीजा? फाइन। वी हैव गैदर्ड हियर फॉर योर प्रोग्राम। नो, दे आर नॉट विजिबल, ओनली यू आर विजिबल देयर।
ओके, सो यू आर विजिबल, कैन यू सी
अस? यू ओनली। You are only visible, not a complete group.
Okay, but students from that
below. Hello.
Just your profile picture
is visible there on the scene.
Okay, now there we go.
Yes.
Can you see us?
Yes, yes, they are visible. Is our group visible to you also?
Yes, it is.
They are there. Yes.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, we can see you on the screen.
Okay.
Okay.
So, shall we start?
Okay, do your students want to start?
Yes, yes. Wait a minute.
Good morning, everyone. We are grade 9 to 12 students here of Birla School, Pilani, Rajasthan, India. We are gathered here to interact under the British Council International School Award activity, that is Inbuilt Heritage. Now, under this activity, we are going to discuss about the different historical monuments of India and Germany. Now, I offer you the mic first to initiate your topic. I request you to please introduce yourself first and then present your presentations.
Okay, we will do so. So, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We're very glad to have this Skype interaction. It just shows us what is possible nowadays, so that Indian students can communicate with German students. My students, they're 11th standard. They take English as one of their main subjects, and we prepared several, let's say, groups of sites. We've got one set of Roman monuments in Germany. We've got churches, the most important churches in Germany. We've got castles as one group, and monuments of our capitals to Berlin, and last but not least, one famous site of our home city, Stuttgart. The students also prepared some slides, so some PowerPoint presentations.
Okay.
If possible, we can share our screen with you, so you can also get the visuals and you get the pictures. Do you want us to start with our first presentation?
Yeah, please proceed for it.
Okay. So actually, we start with the oldest monument in Germany, the Roman monument. You can do it. Okay. Just a second. Can you log in again? It just needs us a second to get the presentation to you.
Yes, it's visible.
Yes. Can you see the Roman monument in Germany written on your screen?
Yeah, it's visible to us.
Okay, so I think we can start the presentation then.
Sure.
We wanted to present you some Roman monuments in Germany. And first, we will talk about the Roman Bridge. And the Roman Bridge is located in Trier and Antioch, and its structure is open and itself. And
language pillars, and it dates from the 2nd century. We need to view it twice after the Second World War, and it's cited as part of the Roman monuments.
So now we will continue with the Limes, and Limes is the more the defense and lighting system of the ancient Rome. Former days marked the boundaries of the Roman Empire, and the Limes Germanicus is the Limes in Germany. It's divided Rome and the unsubdued Germanic tribes, and this Limes Germanicus endued 64 to 900 watchtowers. It was built in the 2nd century, and today they are still part of it in Germany, from northwest to the Danube, it's a river, and today it's also part of the UNESCO World Heritage Site.
And now I'm going to talk about Porta Nigra. It's located in Trier, in Germany. It's built out of sandstone between 186 and 200 AD. It was used as one of four Roman city gates. In the early Middle Ages, the gate was no longer used, and stones were taken away for use, reusing them in other buildings. It was reformed into a church in the year 1000, and in the year 1802, Napoleon reconstructed this building into its original Roman form.
Okay, where are the students? Understandable?
Could
you hear them?
Yes, sure.
Yes? Okay, so that was the first group Roman monuments in Germany.
We also,
You. Now I like to speak on the topic. The Indian monuments, which is one of the seven wonders of the world, the Taj Mahal. Am I visible?
Yes? No? Now you are visible.
Okay. And what about my presentation? It's visible?
You can see the screen, yes.
Is it visible now?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. Now, there are many beautiful and world-seen places in India. But the Taj Mahal is the most attractive of all. The Taj Mahal is a white marble mausoleum located on the southern banks of the Yamuna River in Indian city of Agra. It was commissioned in the year 1632 by the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan to house the tomb of his favorite wife of three, the Mumtaz Mahal. It took 22 long years for the workers to put up a mahal, which is today quite known as the Taj Mahal. The construction project employed 20,000 architects under the guidance of the architect Ustad Ahmed Lahori. The marble tomb is a part of an integrated complex consisting of gardens and two red sandstone buildings. Our Taj Mahal is recognized as the jewel of the Islamic State in India, one of the world's most celebrated structures and a symbol of India's love and rich history. The Taj Mahal is designated as UNESCO's World Heritage Site in 1983, and on 7th July 2007, it was declared as one of the seven wonders of the world too. The sightseeing of Taj Mahal is just mind-blowing. The looks of the bank of the Yamuna River will take your heart away. I must tell you one thing. If you have a heart that beats and to soak the treat the beauty, then you should truly visit the Taj, as the Taj deserves your visit more. Come to the Taj with a bliss and bring the saga come alive. I'm sure you'll definitely fall in love with it. Now I would like to present my mic to my friend who's going to speak on Kutub Minar.
Good morning, everyone. Can you see my presentation?
Yes, you can.
Okay, I'm going to start. My name is Prabhul Kumar and I am going to speak on the topic Qutub Minar. Qutub Minar
is also not included in seven wonders of the world, but it's not less than it. Qutub Minar was built by a Mughal emperor, Qutubuddin Ayubak, in 1220 to beat drums of his glory. This brick minaret is about 73 meter high, that is 240 feet. You can imagine it like around 60 people of average height may stand on top of each other to reach its top. It's 14.3 meter at the base, tapering to 2.75 meter at its peak. Qutub Minar is the highest brick minaret in the world and second tallest minar in India after Fateh Burj. If you are stunned by these facts, you be prepared for a heart to be in your mouth when you see it in Mohali district in Delhi. The walls of this minar has sayings of Holy Quran inscribed on it, and we may leap to the top by a circular staircase consisting 379 steps. His son Iltutmish added three more stories to this giant on earth, and later Firoz Shah Tughlaq rendered restoration for this minar. This red sandstone and white marble construction still stands us spreading the glory and magnificence of the emperor even after 1,000 years. And with this, I would like to hand over the mic to Shitanshu Mishra, who will enunciate more.
So, morning everyone. I'll be speaking and giving a brief description about the Red Fort. Red Fort, are you able to see the presentation? Okay, the Red Fort is one of the largest fort in India. It is situated in Delhi. The Red Fort was the residence of Mughal Emperor of India for nearly 200 years until 1857. It was built by Shah Jahan, the same builder, which was the same person who also built one of the seven wonders of the world, that is the Taj Mahal, in 1638. The Red Fort is the largest monument in Delhi. It is one of the most popular tourist destinations and attracts the thousands of visitors every year. The photo which you are looking at is one of the pics of Diwani Khas. It is a type of auditorium. It is a Shahi Pal where the kings used to sit and make his judgments. Its design was created design was created by the Ustad Ahmed Lahori, who was also the designer of Taj Mahal. It is made up of red and white sandstone. I'd like to tell you that red and white were the favorite colors of Shah Jahan. In 1752, the story of destruction of the Red Fort begins. The Marathas came into the power, and due to some economical imbalance, they have to melt the silver ceiling of the Diwani Khas to raise the funds for the defense of Delhi. Now, this is the Diwani Khas. The word Diwan means hall, and the A Khas is a word which refers to the special people, means a hall for the special people. The photo which you are looking at, once there was a time when the whole ceiling was made up of silver, but it was melted by the Marathas. Okay, now. Every year on 15th August, that is on the Independence Day, the Prime Minister holds a flag at the Red Fort and the nationally broadcasted speech from the rampart. It was designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2007 as a part of Red Fort complex. Now I will hand over the mic to my friend Gaurav Dhingra.
Hello everybody. Good morning, is my presentation visible?
Yes, it is.
As my friend briefed you about the Red Fort, now I'll tell you about the Humang Stop.